And as teenagers become the group with the largest number of COVID cases, doctors are finding a wide range of symptoms. I spoke with an infectious disease specialist at Children's Hospital about what to look for and why children may not spread the virus as easily as adults. Doctors at Children's Hospital are seeing teenagers with COVID falling into three groups. Some have the same symptoms as adults, a fever and cough. Others are completely different.
Up to 50% of children will not have a fever or have a cough. And so it makes it difficult to, when children aren't presenting. So we're talking about nausea, vomiting, diarrhea. We can also see rashes, changes in sense of smell and taste.
Some of the children just have a runny nose.
Basically, any illness that a child may have could be consistent with COVID-19. And so this is a constant battle that a lot of families are having, is trying to sort out, should I get my child tested?
The third group of teens have no symptoms at all.
We just don't have a good handle of how many teenagers are presenting just simply without symptoms. And we're really kind of thinking really long and hard of what's the best way to test and identify these teenagers. But there is a significant proportion that are without any symptoms.
And new studies show children and teens have a lower transmission rate.
But it does seem that children are at lower risk of spreading the virus to others. And so that could be reassuring when we're talking about returning to school.
The demand for testing is up. Wait times for results can take almost 2 weeks.
So what should parents do if they find out that someone their child has been in contact with has tested positive?
What was the type of interaction that person was having? Were they in the same room for an extended period of time? And then also, who was wearing masks and how close in contact was that person with your child?
Doctors say talk to your pediatrician to see if your child should be tested or just quarantined.